Allahu Akbar.
Mahirap ang buhay ngayon, mga ka-news mother, because we're in Syria, in Iraq. Yeah. We are fighting for the Muslim. Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! I don't know.
It's good.
Look at them. Look at them.
So stupid.
We do to the prostate cancer, we, you know,
we cut things and
we take the pain.
Magandang araw, mga kasuso. Welcome to Balitang
Ina.
Yes.
Alright.
My name is Dr. Shamani, and this is our medical vlogs. Yes. What's your name?
My name is Alir
Bunjakul. Alir Bunjakul. Yes. Bunjakul. And today we will show you how to be curing prostate cancer. Now, let's start with defining what prostate cancer is. It starts off as a tumor on the prostate, and then it spreads. But unlike any normal cancer, the spreading of the cancer can be controlled. It's not one by one. It can be everyone, right? So, come with me and let's check out our very first prostate cancer patient. Yes, that's right. And today we will be using the surgical method. Later for the radiation method on our transgender. But right now, surgical method, we will take up the prostate and the seminal vesicles.
Yes.
Guys, ayoko na. Nagpa-check up na ako sa doctor. Sabi nila, may prostate cancer ako. Tapos, ang hirap, kada madaling araw lang, bigla akong may ibig. Tapos yung sex life ko, hindi na siya active.
Hindi na siya tumatayo.
Minsan pag iihi ako may dugo na.
Wow, so
this is my nurse, by the way, Punjabul. And my name is Punjabi Bob. And we are going to cut off the penis from the mans and the transgenders.
Come over here,
We are currently pursuing the patients of prostate cancer.
Open!
You lay down, huh? So we are currently showing you how to cure a prostate cancer. This is how you cure prostate cancer. Resist!
Tulungan nyo, tulungan nyo!
Ah! Wait, sir. Sir, yes, medical vlogs. Doctors, this is the doctor's operation.
This is the penis.
We are here in Wangtuan Medical Center.
Assistant! Doctor, explain everything.
So, we are here today. We are curing prostate cancer. Liz, what are the perks of prostate cancer, Miss Shay? Can you tell us anything about prostate cancer?
Starts in the prostate.
Yes, starts in the prostate. Go. Go.
If it gets worse, the person will have a hard time urinating.
If it gets worse, the person will have a hard time urinating.
He will get blood whenever he urines.
And there's possible erectile dysfunction, yes?
Yes, okay.
That is why we need to cut off the penis before...
Hindi na!
Why?
One debt to society later.
Our next patient is a transgender woman named Venturini. He has a penis. She has a penis. He is just transplanted to him when he decided that she wants to be man. But now, that decision was wrong because she get the prostate cancer. That's right. He will not have any more genitals, but it is fine. It's fine.
Later that same evening.
See, we are done. We are two of the prostate. We are two of the son of the vessel, yeah?
I'm gay!
Babae na lang ako.
Successful na, guys!
Yeah, babae na siya! Babae na siya! Ang tanong, magkaka-prostate cancer kaya siya? We'll find out!
Just pagbalik na ang balita!
News mother! So, that is right. You are a woman, you put on a penis.
No. I was a man before I turned into a woman. Oh. I had my penis removed.
Crazy, right?
Still have you the fetus?
No. I went to the doctor, they said I have prostate cancer.
Oh, shit.
That's why I went to you. I want my prostate cancer to be removed.
I remove your penis and I take off the prostate cancer?
No, because even if I remove the penis, the doctor removed the penis, right? But I still have the prostate cancer. I still have prostate.
Turuhan mo!
Eventually.
Oh! Alright.
This is the radioactive procedure of healing the prostate cancer. This is a transgender woman with the prostate cancer. And we are using the radiation from the Chernobyl to heal the prostate. We're going to heal the prostate cancer to the seminal vesicle. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. It's now healed.
Rena!
So, how was it?
I lost some dignity after the procedure.
And
I didn't lose my prostate cancer, I also lost my dignity. He is a great man.
I'm amazing, right?
Yeah, he is amazing. His assistant was also amazing.
Oh!
What he did was holy.
Oh!
He blessed my life.
Holy shit!
Sample. So, how was it?
It's amazing.
How amazing?
It's not amazing.
Are there any painful side effects? None at all? Mataas pa ba yan? Hindi na.
But I'm hindi ang
process. Sample.
Ah! Reina!
What the fuck?
We're back. So ngayon naman, about sa surgery or treatment sa prostate cancer.
Una, usually may tinatawag tayong active surveillance. Yun yung pag hindi pa lumala yung prostate cancer, parang pinapanood ko pa kung lalala yung prostate cancer. So parang yung doctor, tutulungan ka para may agapan without surgery yung prostate cancer. So, pag lumala na, merong mga choice yung mga tao, mga lalaki para magkaroon ng surgery. So, ano example ng surgery?
Example ng surgery is radical or open prostatectomy. So, a radical prostatectomy is the surgical removal of the entire prostate and removal of the seminal vesicle. So, tatanggalin yung bayag mo. So, ay, hindi.
Yung veins lang.
Yung loob.
Marami ka naman sa, maawa ka naman sa lalaki. Pero, may side effect yan. Usually kasi, pag nagpa-surgery na sa tao ay lalaki, ang nangyayari, nagkakaroon siya ng erectile dysfunction or nahihirapan na siya umihi.
In this surgery, lymph nodes in the pelvic area may also be removed. This operation has the risk of affecting sexual function, kagaya ng sinabi ni Shay.
Ano pa? Meron pa kami ibang examples. Meron ding bilateral orchiectomy. Ito ay surgical removal of both testicles. So, bali, tinatanggal niya yung testicles mo. Wala ka na ganito. Kakasakit ka na ulit. Bago sakit na, wala ka ng testicles.
So, ngayon naman, yung we're gonna talk about the causes of prostate cancer. So, yung main causes niya is age, race, and family history.
So
up in age, Shay?
Around, mga lalaking more than 50 years old in age, must be higher chance sila na magkaroon ng prostate cancer. Sa race naman, must be higher chance yung mga black men compared to white men pag nagkakaroon sila ng prostate cancer. Family history, mas may chance magkaroon ng mga prostate cancer ang mga taong merong, kumbaga na malakas ang dugunan nila yung pagkakaroon ng prostate cancer. Kunwari, kunwari may kapag-anak ka, tapos meron siyang breast cancer. Merong chance na magkaroon yung kapag-anak ng lalaki ng prostate cancer dahil ito. So, kumbaga, yun yung mga dahilan kung bakit nagkakaroon ng prostate cancer ng lalaki. At the same time, hindi yung ano maganda, di ba merong mga, kunwari, pag hindi maganda yung diet mo, magkakaroon ng prostate cancer.
Yeah, minsan din, cause of bad diet yung or unhealthy eating habits, prostate cancer.
Meron din mga overweight na lalaki na nagkakaroon ng prostate cancer dahil nga, yun nga, pag-overweight ka. So, yun din ang dahilan. Kaya dapat, kung ako sa inyo, mga men, mga lalaki, kumain kayo ng maayos.
Be healthy.
Like Mikio. Hello guys.
Okay, so pag nakaramdam ka na...
Oh, umilis na. Back, pangit kami ngayon.
Okay. Alaki naman ako.
Bakit okay.
So, pag nakaramdam ka ng frequent urination, weak or interrupted urine flow, the urge to frequent urine at night, blood sa urine, blood sa seminal fluid, or new onset erectile dysfunction, pain or burning urination, or discomfort or pain when sitting, you probably have prostate cancer.
So, kaya magpa-check up ka lang.
Like, if you feel like madami dito sa symptoms ang nararamdaman mo, magpa-check up ka.
Lalo na pag may dugo yung
heart
yung
sinipo. Yeah, mostly. And pain.
Ngayon, paano kung mag-spray? Mag-spread na yung ano, yung
paano
prostate.
Paano kung may prostate cancer ka na?
Tapos nag-spread na sa ibang parts ng katawan mo. Ang mangyayari, sumasakit na yung buong katawan mo. Yung thighs, ano mo, hips mo, yung back, ayun, sasakit yung my neck, my back.
Yan. Okay, anxiety attack.
Okay. Tapos, ang nangyari, lumamawis yung legs mo. So, pag gano'n, parang magpawis ka, gano'n, nahirapan ka. So, sticky-sticky legs mo, yun. Unexplained weight loss. Pag bigla ka nang pumayat, na walang rason, ayun, lumala na prostate cancer.
Prostate cancer, gano'n.
As pag nanghihina yung katawan mo, pati gano'n. Parang, bigla ka na lang walang energy,
wala,
ayun. Ang
bit so paano.
Stress lang yun. Yung prostate cancer na yun. Kami din gano'n. Tapos pag change in bowel habits. Siguro, pag wala ka na tatahin, o di kaya, nahihirapan ka na tumahin, gano'n. Yun yung, part na, symptoms na paglala ng prostate cancer. Ayun.
We're back. So, ngayon naman, about sa surgery or treatment sa prostate cancer.
Una, usually, may tinatawag tayong active surveillance. Yun yung, pag hindi pa lumala yung prostate cancer, parang pinapanood mo pa kung lalala yung prostate cancer. So, parang yung doctor, tutulungan ka para may agapan without surgery yung prostate cancer. So, pag lumala na, merong mga choice yung mga tao, mga lalaki para magkaroon ng surgery. So, ano yung example ng surgery?
Example ng surgery is, radical or open prostatectomy. So a radical prostatectomy is the surgical removal of the entire prostate and removal of the seminal vesicle. So tatanggalin yung bayag mo. So
hindi.
Ay hindi.
Yung base.
You know.
Grabe ka naman sa maawa ka naman sa lalaki. Pero may side effect yan. Usually kasi pag nagpa-surgery na sa tao ay lalaki. Ang nangyayari, nagkakaroon siya ng erectile dysfunction or nahihirapan na siya umihi.
In this surgery, lymph nodes in the pelvic area may also be removed. This operation has the risk of affecting sexual function. Kagaya nga sila pinishay.
Ano pa? Meron pa kami ibang examples. Meron din bilateral orchiectomy. Ito ay surgical removal of both testicles. So, bali, tinatanggal niya yung testicles mo. Wala ka na ganun. Magkakasakit ka na ulit. Bago sakit na, wala ka ng testicles. Yun. Meron din radiation therapy. So, example na is external beam radiation therapy. So, yun yung pinaka-common sa lahat ng radiation therapy.
Sa light spectrum.
Gumagamit siya ng machine, tapos kumakain ng parang inaano yung beam of x-rays para para ma-detect yung prostate cancer sa katawan. So, parang it helps para matanggal yung prostate cancer. So, ito.
Brachytherapy.
Brachytherapy.
Or internal radiation therapy. Ano yun? So, internal radiation therapy is the insertion of radioactive sources directly to the prostate. So yun, radio. These sources called seeds give off radiation just around the area where they are inserted and may be left for a short time or for a longer time.
So yun yung mga examples. Meron ding mga focal therapies. Ito yung mga less invasive therapies na nag-destroy small prostate tumors without treating the rest of the prostate gland. So yun yung pag medyo hindi pa lumala yung prostate cancer. They use heat, cold, and other methods to treat the cancer, primarily for men with low risk or intermediate risk prostate cancer. So yun yung mga examples ng treatment para sa prostate cancer.
I guess that's all you need to know about prostate cancer.
Prevention, basically healthy diet. Magpa-check up ka.
Prevention is better than cure, guys.
Magpa-check up ka na kagad kung may chance ka or may risk ka of getting. At the same time, watch your diet. Eat healthy foods and mag-ingat ka sa sarili.
Mag-ingat. Take care of yourself, guys.
Tama. So, yun na.
That's all you need to know about prostate cancer.
Thank you for watching.
Prevention is better than cure. Goodbye.